So preaching was very much a one-on-one experience, and it will always be. The only way you can preach is by reaching out to someone's heart. Quickly, slowly, doesn't matter, but reaching out to someone's heart. Touching somebody's heart. And after you touch somebody's heart, and you tell them, here's your plate of prasadam, and here's your glass, and here's some sweet words, and here's your family, and here's so many things which are just waiting for you. And if a person finds what he's looking for with the devotees, then he'll become a devotee. If he don't find what he's looking for with the devotees, he will go away. Like you go away from any place when you don't find there what you're looking for. If you would be convinced what you're looking for your life, is not available here in this mela, you probably stand up within a minute or so, pack your bags and go. Because we are walking towards our destination. And what is our destination? We don't know so clearly. I mean, if we, our faith tells us our destination is Goloka Vrindavan, then we have a destination. Okay. I'm going to Goloka Vrindavan. Really? How you go? Well, by chanting Hare Krishna. Wow! With who do you chant? Well, with my devotee friends. Can I also chant with you? Come on. You're welcome. So it's very, very nice in this world to meet somebody who knows his destination. And it's only in the realm of faith that somebody knows his destination. Save and except if you came from Goloka Vrindavan and you are in contact with Goloka Vrindavan and you are now here just to invite people to come there. But who is that? These are the Nitya Siddha devotees. But whether somebody is a Nitya Siddha devotee or not, that is totally according to your faith. I can only tell you one thing for sure. I'm not one. That I know. So, that means by faith. I have faith in Prabhupada. Prabhupada is a Nitya Siddha devotee. That's what I believe. And there are some other Nitya Siddha devotees I think I met in my life, but whether somebody is on Nitya Siddha or not, whether Goloka is in the face or not, or anywhere else, well, for me, everything is my faith, in my love, in my feeling. And I haven't even met anybody else proposing another destination which could somehow or other compete with Goloka Vrindavan. I mean, no, we are not in a heaven competition, no? It's a bit funny, no? A heaven competition. Who has the best of the heavens? I mean, and if we start talking about the heavens, then we may get even more complicated, because I heard, I don't know so much about Muslim tradition, but the critics of Muslim faith, they say that the jihad, those who die for their religion by going out and killing others, if they die, they go to some heaven where they have a whole bunch of virgins only for them. 50 virgins just waiting for you. Now, I don't know where this idea comes from, that somebody wants to have many virgins or something. But whatever it is, I also don't want to be here out on a critical line of somebody else's heaven conception. Huh? We have the Jehovah Witness heaven, where everybody's sitting around with beautiful trees and the deer and the lions They're also sitting there playing with each other. Wow, we know that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu turned this world into such a heaven when he went through the Jarikandha forest. The deers and the lion were embracing each other. Well, and I heard Swami Yogananda, he wrote in his autobiography of a yogi that there was some yogi who had a vegetarian tiger. I don't know who it was, I don't remember, but in the Radha Gopinath temple, the guru, the grandfather of the guru, is always shown in the pictures with a tiger, so maybe it was him. He was the Raj Guru of the king of Jaipur, and he had a pet tiger. Well, why not? If you give the tiger enough prasadam, why should the poor tiger bother to go around and killing somebody? But if you don't give prasadam to a tiger, I still suspect he'll behave like a tiger. So it's like this, you know, there's many things we have to learn. So the face, facing Goloka Vrindavan, there's so much information about Goloka Vrindavan in our scriptures. It's so sweet. I mean, the whole Krishna book is a description of Goloka Vrindavan. And Srila Prabhupada is the topmost philosopher of describing Goloka Vrindavan. I mean, like, if you have a destiny, what is the destiny you're longing for? Big waterfalls? I got them in Brazil. Great fruits, vegetables. Well, can get that in many places in this world. And somebody said in Swarga, one of the heaven description of Lord Indra, the mangoes are as big as elephants. And when they fall down, they crack open and little rivulets of mango juice start flowing. Interesting, no? I just wonder what happens if you sit under the mango tree and the mango drops. I guess in those places you should not sit under mango trees, because we have some mango trees in Mayapur, and when the mango drops, you hear bang. So, what to say? Everything is here, the different types of heavens and all that what is described. But Goloka Vrindavan is being extremely described as the place of spontaneous, unconditional, pure love running at its maximum speed to the lotus feet of the one and only Lord of Love, who is situated again at the feet of his beloved Supreme Lord of Lover, Srimati Radharani. Something like this, superlative, no? So what is the supreme, the word supreme? What's the superlative of supreme? Tears, ecstasy, passing out, trembling, different devotional symptoms or ecstatic symptoms, transformations, which are described in the scriptures, you know, it's right there. The devotees are completely lost in their love. And this is a description of the feelings which come to you when you approach Goloka Vrindavan. So, yeah, how to describe it, how to put it in words, it's very amazing. And That's the focus of our life. We want to go to Goloka Vrindavan, and Goloka Vrindavan has two sections. It's Svetadvip divided in Goloka and Navadvip. So, in the spiritual world, you can go either into the Radha Krishna section or you can go in the Gauranga Gurganada section. Gauranga Panchatattva section. And there's some devotees I've heard from Jaiva Dharma. They just can't make up their mind. And then they have an internal split, and one part of them goes there, and the other part of them goes there. Don't ask for technical explanations. I just heard that you can become two. To join the unlimited variety of the divine taste if your love is intense enough. I've heard that. I'm not making it up. It wasn't born on my fantasy. But I must honestly say it captures me.